So you just built a WooCommerce website, and obviously it looks pretty basic. Now you can install themes on it and stylize your pages, but you still won't have the ability to customize your product pages and other pages on your website without touching code. But what if there's a way? In this video, I'm going to show you how to customize the WooCommerce product page and other pages on your website without touching a single line of code. Let's begin. So to achieve this feat of customizing our WooCommerce website without touching a single line of code, we'll be using a plugin called SeedProd. It's a fantastic page builder for WordPress. It has a free version which you can use to create landing pages, but you offer the pro version, and that is where all the superpowers of SeedProd will be unlocked, including one of the best functionalities you can ask for, the theme builder. And the theme builder is what we'll be using to customize all our pages, or technically any page you want. Specifically in this video, I'm going to show you the product page, but you can customize any page on your website without touching a single line of code. It's absolutely fantastic. So head to theseedprod.com. The link is on the screen and also in the description of this video. Go check it out. Make sure to purchase the right plan for your needs. If you're customizing just a regular website and if you're customizing WooCommerce, they have different plans. So make sure to purchase the plugin, and you'll find a zip file under your account and also a license key. Make sure to have that ready, and we'll start the process now. So we're inside the admin area of my website, and it's a completely blank WordPress install with WooCommerce. So this is the home page, completely blank, and this is also a product page. I did create a demo product. So this is the product page, the default WooCommerce product page. It's pretty boring, and we're going to spice it up with SeedProd. Back into the admin area, you'll notice I already have SeedProd installed and activated. If you want to do this, you need to go to plugins, make sure to go to add new. And inside the add new options, you'll see the option of uploading your plugin. And what you should do is just take the zip file from your computer, just drag it here and install the plugin. And once it's installed and activated, you'll also see a notification. Hey, enter your license key. Just copy your license key from the admin area from SeedProd's website, paste it in, and SeedProd will be activated on your website. And how you'll know that, hey, you'll see a success message on the screen. Now, inside SeedProd, there's a ton of different options that you can utilize. If I go in the menu here, you'll notice landing pages, theme builder, setup, subscribers, pop-ups, getting all those options. What should you choose with, or what should you start with? Well, you need to start with the theme builder. This is what you should be choosing. And this is what I'm going to start with to explain to you how we're going to work with theme builder. But just let me give you a small preview of what the theme builder does. What the theme builder does is allows you to create as many variations of your theme as you like. Create every page or every template on your site completely customizable based on what you like using the power of SeedProd, and then make any changes whatsoever. Now, if that explanation doesn't help, then I'll just give you a quick demonstration on how this works. Now, since I don't have any theme installed, what I'm going to do is use one of SeedProd's themes to spice up my website and then tell you how to customize it. So what I'm going to do is go to theme template kits, and what this will give me is SeedProd's themes that I can use on my website to spice it up. So I'll go to the WooCommerce options because that's what I'm looking for. Inside WooCommerce, you'll see all these beautiful looking themes that you can use to start off customizing your site, or I'd say just import them on your site and then customize them even further. Now, even if, let's say, some of these websites or some of these themes are not exactly what you are looking for in terms of niche, you have complete control over customization ability. So don't look at the perfect theme, find one that suits your needs, and then you can import and customize every aspect of your theme. That's the entire idea. So let's say if I scroll and I say, hey, this looks pretty nice. If you want to preview any of the themes, just click the magnifying icon here and a new tab will be opened on the screen where you'll be able to just experience the live version of the website, including all these pages. This looks like a cool website, and it does suit my existing honey and milk ladies ebook. So let's say if I'm creating a juicing ebook or any kind of juices I sell online, this looks like a great theme. So I'm going to import this on my site. Going back to my website, I'm going to just click the right arrow or right button here, and this will start the import process on my website. It might take a few seconds, maybe 20 seconds. So let's wait for that to finish, and I'll tell you the next steps you need to do to customize your site. So the import process has completed, and you'll see all these options show up on the screen. Now, you don't need to understand what all of this is, but I'll just explain so that you have some context on what we're doing. Our theme is made up of different templates. For example, when you look at this template, the basic WooCommerce template, it's a template. That means that any product that is present on your store will use the similar format. It's going to have a picture here, the title here, the image here, the button here. And by customizing the template itself, all the different products will automatically use the new template. So each of these options, what you see here is different templates on your site, which you now have control over, which you can edit. The default ones have already been imported. But let me give you an example. If you want to change the product page or customize the product page, you have that ability. If you want to customize the shop page, you have it right here. The single page, that means a blog post or any kind of singulars, you have that option. Single post, that means if you have a page on your site like about page or terms and conditions, you can customize the template here as well. Then the blog index, the home page, the sidebar, footer, and everything on your site is now completely customizable. So instead of customizing or thinking about a specific page, think about the template view of your website, and now you have that customization ability. Now, since this already has been imported, we'll first enable this theme. This is important. I'll click this enable SeedProd theme and enable this. And if you go back here, this page is not refreshed yet. I'll just refresh this and you'll instantly see SeedProd's theme has now taken over and the entire website looks already very beautiful. But let's say you already are at this stage and now you want to customize your website, or specifically, let's say the product page further. Now, what is the steps you want to take? Well, we're going to head back to the admin area and you'll find the appropriate template that we want to customize. Since this is a product page we're working with, we'll find the product page template here, which you can see right here. And you see all these options: edit design, edit conditions, duplicate. Don't worry about this, just open edit design. What I'm gonna do is right click and open it up in a new tab and let it load. And this is the product page template, and this is the SeedProd's editor. The simplest way to explain this is think of it as Lego blocks. You can drag and drop things and you can make sure any changes, and it's completely visual. You don't have to touch any line of code and it's very, very intuitive to understand. I'll just give you a quick demonstration of how you can start making changes. For let's say, for example, now I'm here, I'm looking at these things, and most importantly, what the things that look for on a product page are the heading, the pricing page, the add to cart button, and the images. I'm gonna give you a quick demonstration how you can make any changes to your product page. Specifically, let's start with the heading. So what you can do is, as you're noticing, as I'm hovering over certain things, things are being highlighted. So all you have to do if you want to customize a specific section is to click on it. So if I want to customize the heading, make sure that heading is hovered or heading is being highlighted. I'll click on it and instantly on the left side, you'll see all the options related to the heading are now open up. And this heading is the product title. So this is what you see here. Don't touch this part because the title is being pulled for the specific title. But what you can do is actually customize the look and feel. For example, if you want to change the font size, let's say you want to make the font a little bit bigger, I'll just drag and drop this slider or drag the slider a little higher and make sure it is huge. And instantly you see the changes being reflected right here. Imagine how difficult it is to do this with WooCommerce, and now SeedProd is making it easy like that. And what I can do is also change the alignment. So I can go here and click this, and now alignment is right line or center line. So easy. And if you go to the advanced options, you'll have tons of different options to customize almost everything. So in typography, you can change the font type. So I come in here and the font family is default. If I just go here, you see all these different fonts being already provided inside SeedProd. And I can just choose any font and it will be instantly reflected on the page. And then even further, I can choose the different kind of weights that the font supports, or I can choose a completely different font and also change the font size here. Once again, letter spacing, I can make it bold, I can make it italics. All these options that were practically impossible to do without touching code are now available right here. So let's say this is the font I'm going for and I'm happy with the heading style. If I want to change the pricing options and make sure that it also reflects easily, or it's very, very, I say, easily visible and attractive, then I'll just click on the pricing options. And the product price is now also visible on the left, where you can customize its settings. Again, you have typography options here. So if I go to typography, I can go here and choose any font that I like. But let's say if I just want to change the font size here, I'll just change the font size right here. Now I'm changing the typography of the pricing, the base price, but I can also change the price of the sale price, which is also what I'm going to show you. But let's say, for example, I want to make this the real price also visible so that customers actually see that, hey, the original price is this, but this is what the price they don't have to pay, right? So I can just do this so that this is pretty large, and I can also make it bold if I like, I can make it italics if I like, I can make all these changes and also change the alignment here if I want to. I can also change the sale price. So you see the typography here, this is affecting the regular price. If I want to change the sale price, I'll go here and change the font size to something like this. So now I can make sure that if you have just a few products on your site, you can make sure the pricing is absolutely visible. Nobody can easily miss it, or nobody can miss it even if they wanted to. So this is how easy it is. And if you also want to change the colors, you can go here and change any of the colors. Let's say I want to change this to a little brighter green. I'll just select this option and now it's bright green. Same thing I can do for the regular price or the regular price as well. So imagine this. What I've shown you is you can change the font style, you can change the color, the typography, the size, everything that you want to. Everything is so easy to add to the screen. Now I'm going to show you a couple of additional things that you can do. First, I'll change the style of the button here, the add to cart button. You know, add to cart button is the most important piece of information on the page. So let's click it and customize this. So once you click it, again, the add to cart button has been enabled. If I wanted to, I can change it to center line, I can change it right line, or I can also make it full width, which also looks good, but in this case, it's not looking great. So I'll just stick to the center line. You can also add icons to the button. So if I go here, I can choose before icon, and let's say if I choose glass, since this is a website about juicing, I can choose a glass like this. And now instantly you see the glass icon has been added to add to cart. So easy, anything to do, right? And if I want to, I can just go into the advanced options and again change the typography. Let's not change the typography this time. I'll just change the font size. So I'll just increase this. So if you want to make sure the button is absolutely highlighted on the screen, it's that easy to do. You can also change the font size if you want to, and you can also change the quantity typography. That means this number right here, if you want to change the font just for that, that's also possible. And what if you wanted to make the button a little rounded so that it looks softer? Just drag the border radius down, and now the button looks pretty nice. It matches the theme of the quantity. And I can choose different styles of the button. This is flat. I can have a 2D style. I can also have a vintage style. I can also have a ghost style. And I can have a link style or a custom style. I prefer the flat style, so I'll just stick with it. And you can also change the background color. So I'll give you a demonstration. Let's say if I wanted to make it red, you can make it red. But if you don't like it, you can go back to theme colors and select one of these options, which was this color. So it's absolutely, absolutely easy to make any changes. You can also add shadows and all these different options. The options or possibilities, everything that you can do, let's say in a Word document to change the text styling, you can do right here with SeedProd. That's absolutely easy. But what if you wanted to add more things on the page which are not already visible? Well, that's where all the other features of SeedProd come into play. So once you've made all the changes, you want to go back to all the, let's say, basic option view. Just come here and click this 9-dotted view, which will take you to the blocks view. And these are all the blocks that you have available, or think of them as Legos, which you can drag and drop on the page, and they'll be instantly added to the page throughout your site. Isn't that cool? So let's say, for example, I wanted to add a reviews block. So I'll just search for reviews, and I cite the business reviews, or I can find the recent product reviews. Yes, let's go with recent product reviews. I'll just drag this widget and I'll just move it around like this. And you see this draggable or droppable box that's appearing. This is showing that, hey, if I let go of my mouse, this is where the actual product or actual widget block will be added. So let's say I want to add it right here. I'll click and let go. I'll click here and I'll just click apply. And once the product has reviews, now you'll start seeing all the reviews here. And if I go back, I have tons of different options to choose from. So if you scroll this menu, you have template tags, you have WooCommerce template tags, that means the product price, product meta, product content, short description, long description. So let's say we want to add the short description just here, just drag it here and let go. And now the short description is added. So that's how easy. Not only we can customize the elements on the page, we can add new elements on the page as well. So you have related products, stock information, product data tabs, that means, hey, you have reviews, we have all this data. You can add that, the gallery images, the product price. So anything you want to add to page, let's say if you wanted to add the product pricing once more on the screen, after this happens, you can just take this and you can just add it here and the product price will be visible here. Absolutely easy to do anything that you want with SeedProd. And that's how powerful it is. So once you're happy with everything you've done, for example, obviously the product price here doesn't make any sense. I'm going to delete this. I'm going to, let's say, delete the reviews as well. And let's say the short description and all the font size changed are the changes I want to make. I'm going to take a quick view here if I can find something else. Let's say additional information. So I'm going to drag the additional information right here. I'm going to leave. So if the product has any additional information, it's going to show up here. And below this, I'm going to add the related products widget. So I'm just drag it here and drop it here. And since this website has just one product, so there are no related products, but once you does have much different products, the related products will now be visible here. So in just a few minutes, what I've done is made changes to the theme, made changes to the title, the size, the fonts here, may add add to button, added more elements, remove some elements, and also added a couple of additional elements to the page, which will help with conversions. And of course, you have complete control over whatever you want to do. You can change virtually anything you see on the page can be customized. If you want to change the background color, that's completely doable. If you want to change this, I've already demonstrated a lot of these things. Virtually anything you can click on the screen is customizable. And of course, we have many other YouTube tutorials about SeedProd. So the details of, or I'd say some other YouTube tutorials will be linked in the description. This is just an overview of how you can make those changes. Once you're happy with whatever you've done, just click save. And this template will be saved. Now, every product page has these new changes instantly. That's all you need to do. Just let's go here. And this is the old product page that I demonstrated when I installed the theme. It's not been refreshed yet. Let's click refresh and see this page changed live. And instantly you see the changes live. See, I'm not a great designer. I don't even have any code skills, and I am able to change anything on my site just by drag and dropping, clicking a few buttons. And that's the power of SeedProd. All right. So before you go, I'll just give you a quick demonstration of other things you can change with SeedProd as well. For example, if I go here, these are all the different templates on your site, right? So if you want to change the single page, that means the blog post design, just open it up and you can change the blog post design as well. Let's say you want to have the title not here, you can make it left aligned, you can add a sidebar, remove a sidebar, make any of the changes, and all of this is easily possible. So it's not just WooCommerce or product pages, you can customize any of these things. And one quick feature about SeedProd is you can create multiple variations of templates for different, I'd say, sections of your website. Just for example, if you have multiple categories on your website for products, multiple categories, you can create three variations of the product page. And with using conditions, you can ensure that every single page or every single category has a different look for the product page. This is also possible, just giving an idea of what you can do with SeedProd. Again, I'll link a few videos down in the description, which will explain how to do this. And of course, if you want to learn how to do a specific thing with SeedProd, the comment box is open. You can leave your comments and we'll probably make videos about it anyway, right? So I'm Yuvraj, you're watching W Beginner, and if you have any questions, make sure and leave in the comments. Otherwise, like, share, subscribe, do all that good stuff so we can make more videos for you. All right. Take care, and I'll see you in the next video.